up a little bit, and I want to go to the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 4. And the Bible says that when the apostles so fluently at the things of God, not their things, but the things of God, as the Spirit gave them utterance, and afterwards they preached and wrote the gospel of Christ. Well, they were filled with the gifts of the Holy Ghost, and then all of a sudden they had miraculous powers to continue further the gospel and spread the gospel. Yeah. The Bible says they spoke not from previous thoughts or their previous meditations, but they spoke utterance as the Holy Spirit gave them utterance to speak.
That's right.
Now, the Bible didn't say that the Spirit spoke through them. The Bible says that the Spirit gave them the utterance, that the Holy Spirit gave them the ability to speak.
Well,
he gave them the ability to speak in different languages. And they were even speaking in languages that were not familiar with them. So what that leads me to believe is when I'm out witnessing to someone, I can't say, well, he's only 15, 16, I don't know how to relate to him. Okay? He in the game, he's just, I don't know how to relate to him. Well, I ain't never
smoked crack,
so I don't know how to deal with somebody who's going through a drug issue. You see, he said the Holy Spirit gave him utterance. So if you just stand on the word of God and trust him and begin to minister and testify the goodness of God, he will give you the utterance. He will equip you to say exactly what that person needs. You see, you don't even know everything. You don't have to know everything that a person is going through in order for you to minister the word of God. You see, that's the first mistake you made. You see, you have to be all in somebody's business and know everything that they're going through. We just give them the word of God.